good morning and welcome to our primary lesson today. This week we've been studying and reading in Doctrine and Covenants, section 20 through 22. And we're going to get started with the video. What exactly happened on the day the church was organized?
Chapter 9, Organization of the Church of Jesus Christ, April 6, 1830. Joseph Smith was living in the town of Fayette in the state of New York. Jesus told Joseph it was time for his true church to be on earth again. He told Joseph to organize the church. On 6 April 1830, Joseph held a meeting to organize the church. Oliver Cowdery, Hiram Smith, Samuel Smith, David Whitmer, and Peter Whitmer came to help him. They had all been baptized. Other people also came to the meeting. The men prayed to Heavenly Father. Joseph ordained Oliver an elder in the church. Then Oliver ordained Joseph. Joseph and Oliver blessed the sacrament. They gave it to the men. Joseph and Oliver put their hands on each man's head to confirm him a member of the Church of Jesus Christ and give him the gift of the Holy Ghost. Joseph and Oliver ordained some of the other men to the priesthood. These men were very happy. They said they loved God and told how he had blessed them. Jesus gave a revelation to Joseph Smith at the meeting. Jesus said Joseph was a prophet. A true prophet speaks for Jesus. When a prophet speaks for Jesus, members of the church should listen to him and obey him. After the meeting, many people were baptized, including Joseph Smith's mother and father. What a wonderful day! The Church of Jesus Christ was on the earth again.
I am so thankful that we have the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Being a member of the church prepares us to live with God again. And in obedience to the Lord's commandments, Joseph Smith, Oliver Cowdery, and others organized and restored the Church of Jesus Christ on April 6, 1830. You know, there's one word in there. He organized and restored. Do you know what restore means? Here's a little video to give you kind of a better explanation.
An old bicycle lay on the side of the road. It was worn and broken, and it looked very old. The bike must have been there for a long time. It was rusty and covered with dirt and grime. The tires were flat and the seat was torn. The chain was broken and it was missing the horn. A bike that used to bring so much joy now lay in a ditch nearly destroyed. Most people who walked by the bike just ignored it. But one little boy said, "I'm going to restore it." He picked up the bike and hauled it away. And he started to work on it the very same day. He scraped all the dirt and rust off the frame. And he fixed all the broken links in the chain. He patched the tires and repaired the seat. But this bike restoration was still not complete. He painted the frame a nice bright blue. He tightened the bolts and he tightened the screws. He oiled the chain and he pumped up the tires. And he tested the brakes and tightened the wires. He worked all day and into the night. The bike was starting to look just right. This is the way it was before. My work here is done, and this bike is restored. When Jesus Christ walked on the earth, he called 12 apostles and formed his church. He gave them authority and it was all arranged. But after a long time, the church started to change. Priesthood authority was taken from the earth, and the world was in darkness without Christ's church. People were looking for it for many years. They said lots of prayers, and they cried many tears. Later, Joseph Smith was searching for it, and God told Joseph, "I want you to restore it." Little by little, God showed him the plan, and Joseph Smith obeyed every command. God worked with Joseph both day and night. The church was starting to look just right. This is the way it was before. My work here is done, and my church is restored. For I have conferred upon you the keys and the power of the priesthood, wherein I restore all things, and make known unto you all things in due time.
Okay, here is a picture of a little girl being baptized. And I'd like you to look at the picture and kind of observe or point out things that you noticed about being baptized and this picture. We're going to listen to Doctrine and Covenants, section 20, verses 71 through 74. And let's see how this scripture matches the picture.
No one can be received into the Church of Christ unless he has arrived unto the years of accountability before God and is capable of repentance. Baptism is to be administered in the following manner unto all those who repent. The person who is called of God and has authority from Jesus Christ to baptize shall go down into the water with the person who has presented himself or herself for baptism, and shall say, calling him or her by name, "Having been commissioned of Jesus Christ, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen." Then shall he immerse him or her in the water, and come forth again out of the water.
Okay, so in verse 71, it talks about the years of accountability. And we know through Revelation that is 8 years old. A baby isn't baptized, but until you're 8 years old, is when you are accountable for the things you do. In verse 73, it talks about someone who has the authority from Jesus Christ. So they are called of God and to baptize. Also, another thing is the person who's baptizing goes down in the water with the person being baptized. They don't like stand on the side and watch. And another important thing is that you are called by name. So that's an important one, your full name. And last, I saw that the person being baptized should be immersed in the water all the way under. That's why there are witnesses, to make sure that you go all the way under the water, and then just as important, you are pulled back out of the water. Just like the Savior's example, to be baptized the way he has commanded. We're going to go to Brother Balitz for a song.
All right. We're going to go listen to and sing along with "When I Am Baptized." All right.
Some pictures of things we do in the church that are described in Doctrine and Covenants section 20. So we're going to have some scriptures read and see if we can match up the scripture with one of the pictures. So listen as we read and listen for those key words that will help match it to the pictures.
By these things we know that there is a God in heaven, who is infinite and eternal, from everlasting to everlasting, the same unchangeable God, the framer of heaven and earth, and all things which are in them, and that he created man, male and female, after his own image and in his own likeness created he them, and gave unto them commandments that they should love and serve him, the only living and true God, and that he should be the only being whom they should worship. But by the transgression of these holy laws, man became sensual and devilish, and became fallen man. Wherefore the Almighty God gave his only begotten Son, as it is written in those scriptures which have been given of him. And visit the house of each member, and exhort them to pray vocally and in secret, and attend to all family duties. Every member of the Church of Christ having children is to bring them unto the elders before the church, who are to lay their hands upon them in the name of Jesus Christ, and bless them in his name. Baptism is to be administered in the following manner unto all those who repent. The person who is called of God and has authority from Jesus Christ to baptize shall go down into the water with the person who has presented himself or herself for baptism, and shall say, calling him or her by name, "Having been commissioned of Jesus Christ, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen." Then shall he immerse him or her in the water, and come forth again out of the water. It is expedient that the church meet together often, to partake of bread and wine in the remembrance of the Lord Jesus. And the elder or priest shall administer it, and after this manner shall he administer it. He shall kneel with the church, and call upon the Father in solemn prayer, saying, "O God, the eternal Father, we ask thee in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ, to bless and sanctify this bread to the souls of all those who partake of it, that they may eat in remembrance of the body of thy Son, and witness unto thee, O God, the eternal Father, that they are willing to take upon them the name of thy Son, and always remember him, and keep his commandments which he has given them, that they may always have his Spirit to be with them. Amen." The manner of administering the wine. He shall take the cup also, and say, "O God, the eternal Father, we ask thee in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ, to bless and sanctify this wine to the souls of all those who drink of it, that they may do it in remembrance of the blood of thy Son, which was shed for them, that they may witness unto thee, O God the eternal Father, that they do always remember him, that they may have his Spirit to be with them. Amen."
That was awesome. Great job. What blessings do we have because we're members of the church? Have you ever thought about the special blessings you have as being a member of the Church of Jesus Christ. We're going to go to Brother Baylitz for one of my favorite songs.
Here's an exciting song that you know and you can sing along with. I belong to the Church of Jesus Christ. All right, go.
Okay, I have a package here. It's M&M's. You probably would believe that if I opened it, there would be M&M's inside the wrapper. We're going to read together Doctrine and Covenants, section 20, verse 37, to discover whose name we take upon ourselves when we're baptized.
And again, by way of commandment to the church concerning the manner of baptism, all those who humble themselves before God and desire to be baptized, and come forth with broken hearts and contrite spirits, and witness before the church that they have truly repented of all their sins, and are willing to take upon them the name of Jesus Christ, having a determination to serve him to the end, and truly manifest by their works that they have received of the Spirit of Christ unto the remission of their sins, shall be received by baptism into his church.
What does it mean to take Jesus Christ's name upon us? That means, did you hear? We need to humble ourselves. We need to have the desire to be baptized. We need to repent. And we also need to take the name of Jesus Christ and serve him. How should we think and act because we have his name? We have a song that is perfect explanation for this. If the Savior stood beside me. Let's go listen.
All right. Let's listen to this song, If the Savior Stood Beside Me. All right.
If the Savior stood beside me, would I do the things I do? Would I think of his commandments and try harder to be true? Would I follow his example? Would I live more righteously if I could see the Savior standing nigh, watching over me? If the Savior stood beside me, would I say the things I say? Would my words be true and kind if he were never far away? Would I try to share the gospel? Would I speak more reverently If I could see the Savior standing nigh, watching over me. If the Savior stood beside me, would I often kneel to pray? Would I listen to the Spirit's voice and hasten to obey? Would I count my many blessings? Would I praise Him gratefully? If I could see the Savior standing nigh, watching over me. If the Savior stood beside me, would I comfort those in need? Would I try to show the Savior's love in every word and deed? Would I give to those who hunger? Would I serve more willingly? If I could see the Savior standing nigh, watching over me. He is always near me, though I do not see Him there. And because He loves me dearly, I am in His watchful care. So I'll be the kind of person that I know I'd like to be. If I could see the Savior standing nigh. If I could see the Savior standing nigh, watching me.
Thank you so much for being here and for singing and learning and listening along with us. I have a challenge. So our challenge today comes from Doctrine and Covenants, section 21, verse 5. And it says, "For His word ye shall receive as if from mine own mouth, in all patience and faith." So that's telling us that we need to follow the prophet, because what the prophet says is straight from our Heavenly Father. So the challenge is to draw or write something that you can do to follow the prophet. Because when we follow the prophet, we are following the Savior. I hope you've learned something and had a good day today. We love you. We miss you and pray for you. Be safe and have a wonderful week. We'll see you next Sunday. Bye.